team. My name is Lieutenant General Scott Spellmon, 55th Chief of Engineers and Commanding General of your U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Happy 2023 National Engineers Week. I am privileged to lead some of the world's most talented engineers, scientists, physicists, and mathematicians in the world. Their mission is to apply their ingenuity and innovative thought towards making life safer and more prosperous for everyone. This year's theme for Engineers Week is creating the future. From managing our nation's water resources, to overseeing the design and construction of incredible infrastructure, to innovating through research and development, our experts have an important role in helping to shape the future of our great nation. Behind me is one key example. This is the construction site of what will be the National Geospatial Intelligence Agency's new campus, West. Just like this critical project, much of our work goes to delivering facilities that support the readiness of our warfighters and their families. Let me give you just a couple of examples. One of the ways we're working to help create the future is by supporting the Department of Defense education activity in the design and construction of 21st century schools, not just here in the United States, but at U.S. military installations around the world. Here's a bit more about that incredible program.
Across the world and right here at home, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is supporting the Department of Defense education activity through the Defense Agency's Military Construction Funded Program to replace or renovate current schools to 21st century design standards. These new facilities provide students and teachers with state-of-the-art classrooms, rooms that provide 21st century technology, innovative collaboration spaces, and creative design that enhances student-teacher interaction. These new schools better prepare students for college and careers in the 21st century. USACE and its design and construction partners have built six new schools in the past year, schools like the Patch Barracks Elementary in Germany. This 134,973 square foot, $46.9 million facility accommodates 551 pre-K through fifth grade students. The school design included six neighborhood areas with studios, hubs, and group learning areas, as well as one-on-one spaces. The spaces can be adapted with the help of movable walls.
The school is actually a tool to help teaching and learning, and it fosters, because of the open concept in the neighborhoods and the learning studios, it fosters 21st century skills that we call them the four C's, which are communication, collaboration, critical thinking, and creativity. And the flow between the studios and the interaction between the teachers and the co-planning and the co-teaching allows all of that to happen to better teach our kids.
Military-dependent students in Okinawa, Japan at Bob Hope Elementary have a similar setup in this $72.8 million, 136,155 square foot school. The school also features classrooms without walls, collaborative teaching spaces, as well as bouncing ball chairs and laptop docking stations.
The Corps learns from every single project, the BAOMs learn from every single project, as do we, and I think each project as we go forward gets better and better because of the lessons we've learned from the previous projects. So it's just a great partnership.
Nationwide waterborne transportation is the U.S. supply chain. Nearly half of all consumer goods purchased by Americans pass through harbors maintained through dredging by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Here's a little bit more about our role in helping to create ports of the future.
With 90% of the world's trade conducted via waterborne means and $1.5 trillion in goods flowing through our ports annually, which support more than 13 million jobs across the nation, America's ports need to be ready to receive and ship goods from and to the rest of the world from wider, longer, and deeper drafting ships. USACE, along with its dredging industry partners, are working with the nation's ports to make sure they are ready to receive the ships of the future. Since 2017, the Army Corps of Engineers has worked to deepen nine harbors and connected channels. And currently, it's in the process of working on 12 harbor and channel deepening projects to accommodate post-Panamax-sized vessels. The Corps is also studying an additional nine projects for potential future deepening, keeping our nation at the forefront of commercial trade.
The harbor deepening project here in Charleston was transformational for us. We have the ability to claim for our customers the deepest harbor on the East Coast. And I think that for a region that is dependent on exporting, as well as importing. That extra depth is really a benefit for our customers. It is a benefit for our ocean carriers. It has tremendous positive economic impact on our state.
Today, our engineers and scientists are constantly looking for new and innovative ways to reduce the risk from flooding, especially along our nation's coast. From traditional structures like flood walls and bulkheads to natural solutions like barrier islands, coastal storm risk management systems are some of the most innovative solutions in the country.
Coastal communities, both large and small, are experiencing the effects of sea level change and the associated increase in the extent and depth of inundation due to coastal storms. Throughout our nation, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is partnering with many of these communities to formulate, design, and construct solutions to help mitigate the risks these storms pose. USACE has more than 70 coastal storm risk management feasibility studies or projects that are in the pre-construction and design phase. In the last fiscal year, USACE had more than 90 CSRM projects under construction, which include beach and dune renourishment projects. In addition to 2022 annual fiscal year funding for coastal storm risk management measures, the bipartisan infrastructure law directed USACE to work on an additional $2.5 billion worth of coastal storm risk management solutions. These solutions include structural and non-structural measures and natural and nature-based features like beach berms, dunes, seawalls, flood walls, storm surge barriers, elevating and/or flood-proofing structures to manage risks from coastal storms to neighborhoods and critical infrastructure in vulnerable areas. With nearly 40% of our nation's population living near the coast, investments and work like this will manage risk to economic centers and communities from coastal storms well into the future.
So we've seen more high tide events in the last 20 years than we have in the last 70. We've been tracking the data for a while. And so when you add the extreme events on top of the other issues, you know, we're just getting inundated with flooding pretty frequently, and it's impacting a lot of residents and businesses. So in partnership with the Norfolk District of the Army Corps, we've come up with a recommended plan to hold back at the edge these storm surges, these major catastrophic events.
Again, everyone, happy National Engineers Week. We are proud of our role in applying engineering solutions to help solve some of our nation's toughest challenges and help create the future. If you're interested in a career with us, visit usajobs.com. We're always looking for great talent. SAONS, Army Strong, Building Strong.